if you are like me, you are a little bit worried about the hours that you need to get in order for you to monetize on your Faceless channel. You can get subscribers and you're creating these videos, but the Faceless channels that I'm referring to would be the Kiddies channel. Usually the videos are 4 minutes, 2 minutes, 3 minutes long. The only way to get hours here is if you get a lot of views and that builds up your hours, or you build it yourself. And there's two ways that I want to show you how to build it yourself. If you go to your end tab under your studio, you're able to see your potential to earn via the YouTube partnership program. And the one that I'm interested in is the 4,000 watch hours. And there are ways, the 500, you know, from your audiences, you can do supers and you can ask your audience for support. There's that option. I'm not saying that it's not there, it is there, but I'm more focused on the 4,000 watch hours and 1,000 subscribers. So if you are looking at my stats at the moment, I have 480 subscribers and I need to get to 1,000. This is gradually growing and I'm happy with the growth. This is the one that I'm worried about, the public watch hours. I'm currently sitting at 1,336 public watch hours. I need to get to 4,000 public watch hours in order for me to be asked to join the YouTube partnership program. And the only way I can build this is if I get a lot of views, or if I start building the hours with either a stream or longer videos. That's what I want to show you today. So let's look at the first way. You can create videos that are longer, and there's videos that are longer in a form of creating lullabies. So there's a lullaby video that I created on this channel and it's 40 minutes long. This is the Jungle's Dream Lullaby, and I've clipped together the kind of music that kids can fall asleep to or relax to, and it's 40 minutes long. And if you create something like this and you add it on your channel, once you start getting views, the analytics on this video, it shows me that with this one video that I've created, it already brought 4 hours that I can use towards my hours that I need to monetize. So this tells me if I create a whole lot more videos like this, I can build the watch hours that I need. How we do that? So you can go to your suno.ai. I'll leave the link in the description for you below under the create button. When you're creating these videos, you can type the kind of songs that you want. So if, let's first show you that this is not going to have lyrics. So you're not going to have lyrics on this one. You're going to switch off the lyrics and go to instrumental mode. And once you're in instrumental mode, you're going to write the type of music that you want and give it a title. If you don't give it a title, it won't allow you to create, and then you create. So what kind of music that you could create? Let me show you the one that I've created. I asked Suno to create a calm, soothing sounds of animals in the jungle for kids as a jungle lullaby. So you could tell the AI the type of music that you want, and then you could create it and then edit on CapCut or whatever editing software you're using, so that you have at least a 1 hour long video that you could add on your YouTube channel, and then it starts helping build up those hours. The second one is the one that I'm interested in, and that's streaming. When I wanted to learn how to stream, I struggled with the videos on YouTube because this one talks so fast and this one talks. I'm hoping that when I teach you the streaming, you're going to jump right in and start streaming, and then start building those hours that we need for our channels. If this adds value, please press the like button. Tell me in the comments below, and you say, stream, let's stream and build our channels. Step number one, you're gonna have to build a video. So you cannot stream nothingness. We're gonna come back to YouTube and then the next song starts. So you're gonna do this for all of your videos, and then you're going to export this one longish video. Our work is done now with creating the video. Now we're going to download OBS. We want OBS Studio. So this is the OBS Studio. It's a free software that you could download and leave it on your computer and use it. It records screens, it does streaming, it's absolutely fantastic. You're going to choose which iOS that you use, and you're going to download it so that it's on your computer. Once it's downloaded, you're going to open OBS, and then it launches and it opens up like this. If you're doing this for the very first time, don't let these long screens confuse you. I don't know why it looks like this. It looks like this. What you want to do now is to come to the sources section, is to bring the video that you've created on CapCut to the sources. So you're going to go find your video wherever you've saved it, and you're going to drag it to your sources. Once you've dragged it to your sources, it will start playing. You can pause it because we're not ready. We're going to come back and finish up the settings on OBS. Let's now jump to YouTube and set up our live. Open up your YouTube studio. You are now ready to set up your live. You're going to click where it says create, and you're going to click where it says go live, and the studio live will open up. If you haven't set up your live and your account is new, you might get a message that will say to you, you need to wait 24 hours before it starts letting you go live. And it will also ask you to do your verification. So you need to follow that process that YouTube might show you here in order for you to get a window that looks like mine. Once the 24 hours has gone past, you can now schedule a stream. So you're going to select schedule a stream, and a box is going to open up. If you've done it before, it'll say reuse the settings from the previous live. We want to set it up from new. So we're going to click where it says create new. And then it allows us to create a brand new stream. The details are the title that you're going to write for your live. I always use ChatGPT to help me with title ideas, and I ask to give it to me, and I pick one of the titles that are usually very good because it's AI, and then I paste the title there. And you will see with VidIQ, it'll rate the title, how findable or how searchable is it. If it's not above 80, I pick another one. If I've asked ChatGPT to give me more than one, and then I want a one that's going to actually be foundable like this one. This is 82. Chances it's green. I love that. So my title is done, and then my description. I always put my defaults on my settings for all of my videos, including the lives now, of websites that I usually use, like my Canva and my sound effects and my, you know, all of your normal links that you usually use. You can always set them up on your settings on your studio so that they are there. But above that, you can add the description. Again, I asked ChatGPT to help me with the description, and then I copy the description from there. And if you don't like the emojis that it has added for you there, you can just paste it, read it through, and delete some of the emojis if you don't want them. Or you could create your own description. There's not a problem about that. So we're going to use software because we're using OBS for the live, and therefore we're going to leave it as streaming with software. And then we scroll down the category. You pick the category that you're in. We are in education, so we're going to pick an education category, and then we select a thumbnail. Same principle as your thumbnail that you use for your YouTube videos. Create a thumbnail that is going to be catchy. So I created one for my live. I added live on, and it's lively so that people can scroll and be notified of my live when it goes live. So create one using Canva. If you don't have Canva, you can always sign up with my link in the description below. And then you scroll down to playlist. Always create playlists. It makes your content be consumed better by your audience. So create playlists and make sure that you have categories for the different kinds of videos that you create. So this is a live. I would add it under my lives or streams, and I would pick the playlist there. If you don't have one for lives, you could create one by saying new playlist, and then you click on done, and then you scroll down. This is a live for kids, so I'm going to select yes for kids, but it depends on the kind of content that you're creating, whether it's for kids or not. And then when you click on show more, if you've been paid to create this live, you need to tick this one that says This is done for sponsorship or endorsement. So follow YouTube's guidelines and follow YouTube's rules. Mine is not, so I'm going to leave that blank. And then I scroll down to altered content. Then you read through. If you have somebody on your live that appears that you made them talk and it's not them, then you have to tick yes. If you've altered footage of a real event or a place, then you have to tick yes. If you've generated a realistic looking scene that doesn't actually occur. Some of my videos, I did create scenes that were used from AI, like when Zoe was talking. So I will tick yes because I've used AI to create some of the videos that I've added on my video that's an hour long. So I would use yes. YouTube loves AI. So don't shy away from saying yes, because you don't want to be caught saying incorrect things or lying to YouTube and then your channel get demonetized because you didn't speak the truth. And then you scroll down and you add your tags. My coach says tags are old news. You know, you could add tags to say kids live or toddlers music, sing along. And then you add your tags following the tags that you want to add up until 500 characters. And then you scroll down, you look at the settings that are applicable to you, and then you click on next. Then now we are at customization. We need to customize the live. Do we want a live chat? We could, but for kiddies channels, you can't have a live chat as far as I know, because it is a kiddies. You can't comment on a kid's channel. And then the participating modes. This is very important if you are creating a live for grown-ups, because you could allow anyone, you could allow subscribers, you could allow live commentary if you want. I'm going to leave it as anyone, but I don't think it's applicable for us because we are a kids channel. And then you could also have live reactions. You leave that as be. The message delay, if you're not on a kids channel, you could use this to grow your YouTube channel by making people subscribe before they respond, like this one. You can make them wait to respond. They need to subscribe first before they respond. So you could have a slow mode, and you could put like a number of days or the number of times that people must wait, 300 seconds or how long you want, in order for people to wait before they comment, before they send you messages. So this is not applicable for us because we're a kids channel. People can't comment on a kids channel. But if you are a grown-ups channel, this is very useful if you are growing a channel and you want subscribers. Next, we are going to choose visibility. It would either be private, unlisted, or public. We're going to select public, and we want to schedule it. So we want to schedule it for a couple of days. This is another way you can promote your content. If I schedule it for tomorrow, for example, at 2 p.m., from now until 2 p.m. tomorrow, YouTube is going to publish the thumbnail and show people that Zanele has a live upcoming, and people can be aware of the live that's coming. They can sign up to say that, notify me when the live starts. So this is another way that you can promote your live to people by making sure that you publish it, but it is not live yet, so that people are aware that it's upcoming, and then it helps you grow your channel. Once you're done, you click on done, and we are almost done. So you could click on stream setup and have YouTube help you, but what we need in this section, and let it not frazzle you, we want this key. This stream key is what we need to go and add on OBS so that we can activate the live. So what do we do now? That you're going to copy and you're going to go to OBS and paste it there and link the live so that it's live. It's really not that complicated. So even though it looks daunting, it really isn't. So we've copied the stream, we've set up the live and the thumbnail and whatnot. We're going to go to our OBS. Once we get here, we want to go to settings. So we're going to go file, open our settings, and then we want the stream. So we open the stream and then we pick the YouTube service from the list. So pick the one that says YouTube RTMPS, and the server, you're going to click on the drop down and choose the primary YouTube ingest server. You leave it as that. And then you could connect your YouTube account. It says recommended. However, we're just going to use the key that we got from YouTube and use that. So we're going to click where it says use stream key. And then this is the key. You're going to highlight if you've pasted one before and just paste the one that you just got from YouTube. And you paste it over there and you click on apply. They will show you the bit rates that are required for a streaming and the audio bit rates. And then you click on okay. Now our setup is done. The last important settings that you have to do is to go to your audio mixer and make sure that the 1 hour live stream, the video that you're busy going to stream, is the one that is the only one that has audio. The rest, which is your desktop, it needs to be completely on mute, as well as your mic. Because if you start streaming and the mic is on, it's going to be heard by people who are watching your video because you've left these two settings on, and it's going to make your stream absolutely ugly and bad. And then you click on start streaming, and then it's up and running. The status is good and we're all good. We've activated the stream and it's linked and it's working. That's how you stream using OBS. When you are done streaming, you can click on end stream, and then it will allow you to make changes on editor, that you can find it under your content. The last thing I do want to show you is once you end your stream, you will be allowed to go to the editor, but you need to take note that it takes 24 hours or longer for YouTube to process your stream in order for you to make any changes under editor. So if you have run into things that you want to change, you can always make it private and then change it back to public once you've fixed whatever you wanted to fix. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, share, and go watch our next video that's going to teach you how to create an awesome animation using Canva. Thank you so much for joining me today. I do appreciate you. I will see you with our next video.